Hey, shalom, greetings, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's Brother Todd the Doc. And again, this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counselor, and then please be advised. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. I wanted to talk to you about jurisdiction and how to properly question jurisdiction. But I also want to make note of, if you actually need any type of personal coaching, some type of direction or guidance, feel free to click the email link below and someone will be in contact with you. If you actually want to become a secured party creditor, click the email link below and someone will be in contact with you. Or if you'd like your credit cleared, if you'd like these bill collectors to stop harassing you, then also click the email link below and someone will actually be in contact with you. The information that I'm about to give you in this video, if you find this information informative, you'd love to show your appreciation by donating for my time, energy, and education, just simply click the PayPal link below and then donate whatever value that you think this video and the information in this video is worth, be it 50, 100, 20, 10, 5, or even a dollar. With that being said, I wanted to talk to you now about how to question jurisdiction. Now, you must know who you are and how your status actually fits in. And it does not fit in with the state and with the de facto or the federal government. So in order that you separate yourself from their jurisdiction, consider first your mailing address. Now, I have a question. What is an address? And you may answer 2617 Church Avenue, Brooklyn, New York, 11203. But I want you to consider this. Now, can you trade, can you sell, or give away any particular address or zip code? No, it's not your property. Now, the street address actually essentially belongs to the municipal government in which it is actually located, and the zip code actually belongs to the U.S. Postal Service. Is the zip code necessary for mail delivery? And the answer to the question is no. Now, are you a resident? Res, or yes, is a very interesting word. Now, simply, it means a thing. But, however, I suggest that you look it up in a legal dictionary, such as Black Laws 4th. Look up the word. And, of course, I mean, you could actually recognize the word ident as an identification. And when you put them together, what do you have? You have resident. Thing, identification, a thing identified. Are you a resident? And domicile. Now, I feel that you may begin to think a little different and say things differently once you properly receive this information. Now, consider this, this addressing scheme. I am a living soul. Domicile on the land in the Republic of California, the Republic of Texas, and so on and so forth. Mail reaches me at the following address. I mean, you simply write your name and remember, spell it in proper form. No all uppercase nonsense. Without prejudice, UCC 1-308, non-resident, non-domestic, first-class, U.S. delivery. Care of, whatever the street address is, Los Angeles, California, New York, New York. You know, that's the state. And that's it. If you're going to use a zip code, for informational purposes, you're going to put those in brackets. Now, there is a C/O in front of the street address, in cure of. You could actually use the words in cure of or just cure of. Now, what's important, the important thing to notice here is that you, as a non-resident, thing to notice here, brothers and sisters, you, as a non-resident alien and foreign national American to the corporate de facto government, may receive mail in care of the so stated address. Do you understand? So you do not have to accept it per UCC. Mail put into your postal reception box or your slot. You only receive it there, and that you may receive it without prejudice per UCC 1-308. So also use the full spelling of every street name, north, south. You're going to write out the letters New York. You're not going to abbreviate NY. Because abbreviations are a benefit and also copyrighted by the U.S. Postal Service. So the Postal Service, which is actually a corporation, assume all mail to be domestic until you give notice per UCC. Otherwise, therefore, insert the phrase non-domestic, as I just went over. Now remember that the example that I just gave is for both sending and receiving. And you could actually have a rubber stamp made or have your envelopes printed accordingly. Now, it works fine with the post office and it begins to separate you from them. Do you understand? So the use of the two letters, such as the abbreviation, state abbreviation, is also a benefit. And always spell out the name of your state, even if it's Mississippi, California, etc. And be proud of your state. You don't go around saying MS, CA, TX, NY, or the like. Or do you? Now, on as far as zip codes are concerned, now, the use of commercial zip code is voluntary. And if you doubt it, matter of fact, don't believe me, go and check it out for yourself. See domestic mail manual section 122.32, and also, and the benefit, shall I say. So, in the example that I gave with the zip code, I actually suggested that you put them in brackets, is for courtesy purposes only. So, some enlightened people are actually choosing not to use zip codes at all. So the post office, not the postal service, can actually find someone almost anywhere and do so without a zip code. So an address with a zip code number creates a federal jurisdiction, a market venue, or a revenue district that overrides the state boundaries. Do you understand? So the use of a zip code number is actually a benefit and takes you out of the state venue with the Constitution's protections and moves you into the international commercial venue involving admittee concerns of the corporate United States. Do you understand? So the United States government is a commercial corporation domiciled at Washington, D.C. And if you doubt it, visit your local post office and look at the 2015, if they have one out yet, National 5-Digit Zip Code and Post Office Directory. And the first sentence of the explanatory paragraph says, a zip code is a numerical code that identifies areas within the United States and its territories. Zip code alignments do not necessarily adhere to boundaries of cities, states, or other jurisdictions. So, question begs to be asked. The United States and its territories certainly looks like the corporate United States to me. So, Now let's have another look at another United States Postal Service publication, the International Mail Manual, IMM. 792 definitions of terms. And 792.1, resident, is defined as a resident of the United States includes any firm that has a place of business in the United States or is incorporated or otherwise organized in the United States, its territories, or its possessions. 711-1, which is subject to examination. All mailing originating outside of customs territory of the United States, i.e., outside of the 50 states of the District of Columbia and Puerto Rico, is subject to customs examination. So, brothers, sisters, as you can see, they recognize the difference. So, an interesting side note is that the zip code directory is actually fully copyrighted with notice on every page, whereas the IMM is not copyrighted. So the zip code directory goes on to say how the zip code benefits you. And they tell us that the zip code is a benefit. Do you understand? And you know what happens once you accept the benefit. So you may consider preparing and filing an affidavit, certificate of citizenship, as an administrative notice. And it would actually help in establishing just who you are. Who are you? So look up the word artifice in a legal dictionary. And perhaps from time to time you may find an artifice or two in your mail reception box. Look it up. Constitution for the United States of America. Now, Article 3, Section 1. The judicial powers of the United States shall be vested in the Supreme Court and such inferior courts as the Congress may, from time to time, ordain and establish the judges both of the Supreme and inferior courts shall hold their offices during good behavior and shall at stated times receive their services and compensations which shall not be diminished during the continuance in office. And Section 2 says, the judicial power shall extend to all cases in law and equity arising under this Constitution that the laws of the United States and territories made or which shall be made under their authority to all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers, and consuls to all cases of admiralty maritime jurisdiction. 2, controversies to which the United States shall be a party to controversies between two or more states. So brothers and sisters, in all cities affecting ambassadors and other public ministers and consuls, and those in which a state shall be a party, the Supreme Court shall have original jurisdiction. The Supreme Court shall have original jurisdiction, both as to law and fact, which acts with such exceptions and under such regulations as Congress shall make. Do you understand? Do you understand? I hope you're getting this, folks. I really hope you're getting this. We're talking jurisdiction here. The jurisdiction of these federal de facto. Do you understand the true nature of the government? Do you understand how this thing is going down? Or are you beginning to awake to what's really going on? If not, I hope that you wake or you awaken soon. So, if you actually found the information in this video informative and of value, then please show your appreciation by donating whatever value that you think this video is worth. And remember, if you would like to clear your credit, have these debt collectors stop calling you, click the email link below this video, and hey, someone will be in touch with you. If you would like to become a secured party creditor, get in your proper status, click the email link below this video and someone will be in contact with you. And again, if you would like to donate, click the PayPal donate link below this video and donate whatever value that you think that my time and energy in this video is worth. So until next time, Tyler Dawkins, Shalom. Peace and blessings.